John Gill, 1 John chapter 5, verse 9, scripture, quote, if we receive the witness of men, end quote, John Gill, the witness of sufficient number of credible men, of men of good character and report, is always admitted in any case, in any court. It was allowed in the law of Moses. Everything was proved and established hereby. Upon these men were justified or condemned, their cognizance was taken of men's sin, and punishment inflicted, yea, death itself, Deuteronomy 17:6. And even in this case, concerning the Son of God, his coming into the world and the dignity of his person, the testimony of men is credited as that of the wise men who declared that King of the Jews was born, and a star had been seen in the east, which Herod himself gave credit to, and upon it summoned the chief priests and inquired of them where he should be born, and also the shepherds who testified to the appearance of angels, who told them that there was then born a Savior, which is Christ the Lord, and who also related that they themselves saw the infant at Bethlehem, and especially of John the Baptist, whose testimonies were true, could not be objected to by the Jews themselves, who sent to him, before whom he bore a plain and faithful witness. Now, if any human testimony may be, and is received, quote, scripture, quote, the testimony of God is greater, unquote, more valuable, sure, and to be more firmly depended on, since it must be infallible, for God cannot be deceived, nor can he deceive. Scripture, quote, for this is the witness of God, which he hath testified of his Son, unquote. Even the witness of the Spirit, the water, the blood, is the testimony, not of men, but of God. The gospel attended with the Spirit of God is the testimony of God. And so the ordinances of baptism and the Lord's Supper, which bear witness of Christ, are not of men, but of God, and especially the witness of the Father, the Word, and the Spirit, must be the testimony of God, since these three persons, they are one, particularly the witness that which God the Father testified of his Son, Jesus Christ, at his baptism and transfiguration, must be allowed to be the testimony of God, and far greater than any human testimony, therefore to be received. End of 1 John chapter 5, verse 9.